Hello friends, in this video we'll talk about interesting facts about regression analysis. Now, interpolation and extrapolation using regression equation. In linear regression, a single numerical independent variable x is used to estimate the numerical dependent variable y. If x lies outside the range of a given observation, the prediction is called extrapolation, and if x is inside the range of given observation x, the prediction is called interpolation. If x varies from 14 to 26, and if we want to estimate y using x, where x value is outside the range, say less than 13 or more than 26, say 35, then it is called extrapolation. For the sake of completeness, if we want to estimate y value using x, where x is 21, which is within the range, say between 30 to 26, then it is called interpolation. One of the most common errors of using linear regression analysis is that of extrapolation. One major regression assumption is that the input data is from within the range of original data. Next, regression forecasting. That is, using data outside of the range of original input data can produce some unbelievable results because we do not know what is the exact relationship, linear or nonlinear, outside the observation range. As an example, let there be a linear regression equation describing the relationship between a child age and IQ levels. And suppose we applied that linear regression equation for input data for adults. That would produce completely spurious results. So, one of the major regression assumptions is that all input data must come from within the range of original input data. Now, measure of variation. Let xi, yi be some observations or known data pairs. Y bar is the mean of variable y and yi hat is the estimated value when input is xi. We may apply following relationship. Total sum of square SST is equal to explained variation SSR and unexplained variation SSE. So what is SST? SST is what? I is equal to 10, summation of yi minus yi bar. What is SSR? Summation of I is equal to 1 to n, yi hat minus y bar square. And what is SSE? Summation of I is equal to 1 to n, yi minus yi hat square. Now, coefficient of determination. The coefficient of determination measures the proportion of variation in y that is explained by the independent variable x in the regression model. It is a measure of how closely the regression line fits the data. So R square is what? SSR by SST, just in the previous slide we have identified SSR by SST. So SSR is what? Summation of I is equal to 1 to n yi hat minus y bar whole square divided by summation of I is equal to 1 to n yi minus y bar whole square. A large value of R square indicates a stronger linear relationship between these two variables. The value of R square should be in between 0 and 1. So if R square is equal to 1, total variation explained by the regression and all the points lie on the regression line. That is, there is a perfect linear dependence between the variables. If R square is equal to 0, the explained variation is 0. In this case, there is no linear relationship and true regression slope is probably 0. Now, practically, for better regression model for engineering application, we expect R square should be greater than or equal to 0.90. But the fields like social science and business, we accept lesser value. The R square value is very much sensitive to number of data n and number of independent variables k. And we require n should be very, very larger than greater than k. And desirable is what? N should be 10 into k. Application of coefficient of determination. If we intended to use regression for prediction, then higher the R square value, the more accurate will be our predictions. If we are interested only in the understanding the relationship between the variables, then lower R square value may be accepted, as long as we realize that the model does not explain much. Now, standard error of estimate, mean square error, or standard deviation of regression error. The standard error of estimate is the standard deviation around the prediction line. The formula for standard error of estimate is as follows. So MS is what? Summation of I is equal to 1 to n yi minus y hat square divided by n minus k, where k is the number of variables. Here the value of k is 2. The error variance S square is an important parameter which is a measure of the spread of the population data about the population regression line. The error variance sigma square is usually unknown, and the unbiased estimate of the error variation sigma square is the S square. Now, residual analysis. Now, residual analysis is used to evaluate the assumptions and determine whether the regression model selected is an appropriate model. The residual error is EI is equal to YI minus YI height. The residual quantify the unexplained portion of the model. Now, residual plot. A residual plot is a graph that shows the residuals on the vertical axis and the independent variable on the horizontal axis. If the points in a residual plot are randomly dispersed around the horizontal axis, a linear regression model is appropriate for the data. Otherwise, a nonlinear model is more appropriate if the plot pattern are non-random U-shaped or inverted U-shaped. Then it suggested a better fit a nonlinear model. So you can see, if it is a random, then linear regression is appropriate. But if it is a U-shaped or inverted U-shaped, then their nonlinear model is suggested. Thank you very much. In the next video, we'll talk about angle between two regression lines.